It's time now to bring in yet another guest, an important one, Mr. U.R. Bhatt, Managing Director at Dalton Capital Advisors, joining us on the show. Mr. Bhatt, we missed you on Diwali, so I wish you a very happy New Year.
Thank you.
Let's start off first with, obviously, we're in the midst of the earnings season, more positives than negatives.
As of now, I think it is on that side, but you know, quite a lot of the results are yet to come, especially the public sector banks, the big ones are, I mean, except the biggest one, others have not come. So I think that's a very important sort of turnaround story, if at all it happens. So therefore, I think we have to wait, because typically the worst results come last. So therefore, we can't really be celebrating too early.
But is the mindset changing a bit, do you feel? Is it a more risk-on sort of a trade now?
Well, I think the sentiment has changed a bit, especially with this talk about personal taxation, some flip there, even though I think there is some denial also there. So therefore, that is one that is keeping the market sentiments high. Plus, of course, you have seen even the festival sales have been reasonably much better than what was initially expected. So probably there are some green shoots somewhere. But I think, I mean, after all that, we have to see that we are inches away from the historic highs. So we already factored most of these in already.
Actually, that was going to be my question. Do you reckon at these levels, with the earnings that we have, the markets are baking in the positives from the divestment phenomenon, which is the government speaking about, as well as potential personal tax cuts? Are we baking that in already?
I think so, because we are very nearly at historic highs. So therefore, I think most of it is baked in, because the results don't seem to suggest that there's a big turnaround and there's going to be a big improvement in earnings.
But potential earnings recovery, again, I take on board the point, but one, that the delivery of the 25 Nifty companies and some broader market companies have been good. And SBI's commentary that Devina was referring to the other day, Rajneesh Kumar spoke about recoveries coming in, the analyst meet speaking about the second half being much better.
Yeah.
And if SBI is saying that, maybe the same might hold true for ICICI, Axis, and some of the other large corporate facing banks too. Are we staring at therefore maybe potentially slightly better earnings performance than what the market would have believed before SBI commentary?
Yeah, I think so. On the margin, I think that's a very important positive for the market, and that's why the market has been going one way for the last several days now. In addition, you had at least the FIs top selling and some incremental buying, of course, except yesterday was a big one. But otherwise, I think they have been marginal buyers for the last 4 or 5 days. But I think these are the things that are keeping the market up. But I think given the fact that we're very nearly at historic highs, there might be some resistance at these levels.
October is still going to be a net negative number in terms of the FII flows.
Yeah.
And it's been some time now since the interest has really kept the stock markets afloat, but we're still doing okay for ourselves, 11,900 now on the index. Do you feel that you're setting yourself up for a slightly larger move in the near term? Disruptions will come about, but with the kind of government policies and the initiatives the government's taking, but that's going to become a strong foundation on which growth will take place going forward. And that's the time that, if the FII interest comes in a big way, who's to say where the index can go?
Absolutely. I think we're certainly in a much better place than what we were about a month or two ago.
This is still a right time to invest.
I think the international events are very important, because the big delta will be from FIIs. So the FIIs have not been great supporters of the Indian market for quite some time now. And if you really see even the big thing, that is the US-China trade war, there seems to be newer hiccups coming up there. So unless that sort of at least phase one is settled, I don't see FIIs coming in big numbers, and the risk on internationally at least taking shape in a very big way.
Yesterday's number two propped up in part by the HDFC Life deal, otherwise it may not have been as good. Now, Mr. Bhatt, two or three months ago, fundamentals may not have been in place for the autos, but the prices were. Now the prices have also inched up. Maruti is admittedly up, 30-35 odd percent from those 5500 levels. Everything else has moved up too. Are the autos already pricing in the revival in sales that we might see in October, and if November continues, then that? Or do you believe that if those data points come positive, then you might see a further uptick here in these prices of some of these larger names?
Well, I think most of the auto names are really factoring in potential turnaround post April 2020.
Oh, really? That
I think
out.
So. That okay. far out, because you know, because of this BS6 and issues like that, I mean, there might be some pickup suddenly, because I think there's a lot of inventory emptying that is going to happen now, because people, I mean, all these manufacturers cannot manufacture even one car or one vehicle after March 31st, and so therefore they are going to wean away in inventory. So there might be some incentives to sell the BS4 compliant vehicles. So I think this is not exactly a trend that is going to really determine the future of these stocks. So I think April 20 onwards, probably not even the first quarter of 2021, but the second quarter of 2021 is when I think markets will start to stabilize for the auto stocks. And I think that is what is factored in this run-up that you're seeing.
Yeah, who would have thought, right? I mean, look at this three-month charts. Who would have thought that amongst the best performing sectors in the last 3 months would be the auto pack? TVS Motors, 41%, Maruti 37%. These are some stunning gains by some of these auto names in the last 3 months. The other pack, and I don't want you to comment on specific stocks, yeah. but since the Infosys whistleblower complaint came out, there has been a stark underperformance of Infosys vis-a-vis TCS. Now, at some point of time, do you see there being course correction? I don't want you giving me a stock view, but how serious do you believe this allegation around Infosys are, or are they overdone from a fundamental understanding perspective?
Well, no one knows the facts there. At least the market doesn't know the facts. So therefore, I think market just reacted to whatever got published in the media. But I think that said, most of the IT stocks really have pared down growth numbers quite dramatically over the last, say, about couple of years, and the valuations have to catch up with these lower numbers. And that has not happened. So I think there could be some sort of a time correction in these, because when these are market favorites, they're a very important part of the indices, so therefore they may not correct dramatically. But I think a time correction is probably warranted in quite a lot of these IT stocks, because there's a huge mismatch between growth numbers, earnings growth numbers, and valuations.
Few themes, Mr. Bhatt, diagnostics.
Yeah.
Then insurance. Mm. These are areas where the interest has been brewing, yeah. and pretty active in terms of stock price. Paints, obviously, and not just Asian Paints. You've seen Berger. The valuations are steeper than Asian Paints now. These pockets continue to drive, according to you?
Well, I think these are
are they just seasonal flavors that come about?
Yeah, they are rushed to safety sort of, because I don't think there can be a valuation argument in quite a few of these things. But it's just rush to safety, sector rotation, because people are tired of doing the same things all over again. So I think these are all sort of seasonal favorites. I don't think at these valuations there can be a huge upside to these stocks.
Why would you say rush to safety? I mean, the industry is growing.
Yeah.
If diagnostic space, a very underpenetrated market. Mm. Paints, in the next 3 to 4 years, 50,000 crore, this is what Abhijit Roy said, it's going to become a 50,000 crore industry. The growth potential is significant. Insurance, which Indian doesn't take insurance? So why would you say it's just a rush to safety?
Insurance is a new sector. So therefore, it is a sort of process of discovery of these stocks. And I know these stocks, quite a few of these stocks will get into larger indices, and so therefore there will be a lot more institutional following. So that is a discovery story, and the same with the sort of diagnostics. Maybe there's under penetration, but I mean, I was talking more about paints because at these valuations, I don't know how you can. I mean, the sort of assumption there is that they will grow forever at these numbers, and even the PEs will remain at these levels. So which is very difficult for us to sort of say that, you know, these will quote at whatever 70, 80, 90 PEs, and they are growing at, you know, just marginally double digit numbers, if at all. So therefore there is a huge disconnect there. Sometime this will get corrected. It may not be day after tomorrow, but sometime these things have to get corrected.
Yeah, they certainly have to. Mr. Bhatt, then my final question really is on a beaten down pocket that is just showing some signs of green shoots. You referred to the trade tensions easing.
Yeah, yeah.
Metals have started probably seeing the first signs of that optimism.
Yeah, yeah.
Valuations are in favor. Do you think it's a pocket that one can bet on?
Possible, but I mean, these are all trading buys.
You're not really.
I think you have to really keep track of what is happening internationally and take these bets. But say, for example, if yesterday's growth numbers in the US are something to go by, there might be some, there might be some story there. Hmm. But that said, Chinese growth numbers are not exactly looking very great. So because China is the biggest buyer of most of these commodities, so therefore one has to sort of balance these out and see how the futures are sort of quoting, and then take a bet on these.
Okay, we'll leave it at that.
Thank you,
Mr. Bhatt. Thank you so much for taking the time out.
My pleasure.
And Happy New Year.
Thank you very much. Same to you.